Hey guys, I'm coming at you with a quick little update. This is going to be a very short video. Just to show you where I'm at with the RX-7 R1 from Tamiya. And right now we're working on the interior. And I'm going to tell you what I found and why this is taking a little bit longer than I expected. As there are certain things I want to do. And I want to see if I'll be able to pull them off. Okay. This is where we're at with the interior so far. Might remember from the last video, the dashboard is done. I have attached the. Let's see if we can't zoom in a little more, give you a little clarity there. All the gauges are in, all the instruments are painted, steering wheel has been attached. So this is pretty much as done as it's going to get for the dashboard. It is the right-hand drive dash, as you can tell, using the Japanese spec steering wheel. Funny thing is, if you look at the instruction sheets, they only give you the instructions for the left-hand drive vehicle. Let's bring this over here a little bit. This is all you really get in the way of instructions from Tamiya. They don't really make provisions for building the right-hand drive vehicle in this kit, even though they provide you a whole separate sprue tree for the right-hand drive parts. So I decided to go with the right-hand drive parts, but you'll find that the instructions are basically the same for the right and left-hand drive. Just add the steering wheel and the instrument clusters on one side or the other. So as you can see, that's all done. We're all nice and done there. Now, as far as the interior goes, I'm right now working on the seat belts. Let's take a look at the rear seat belts first. From what I saw while I was doing a little research on this car, there are 3-point seat belts in the rear that are attached about at the halfway point on the lower cushion, either to the center tunnel area or here on the edge. Now, what I did to mount these were I cut 2 small openings on each side of the lower cushion, fed the seatbelt material, which this is what I use for the seatbelt material. You can get this at any Hobby Lobby. This stuff is great. And one roll will do literally more cards than you'll finish in several years. And this, I think, is only about $2. So what I did, I just fit it through there, glued it at the top here with a little super glue, attached the buckle with a little super glue, the other half of the buckle there. And there you go, you have seat belts. Let's take a look at the front seat. Here we have the front seat. Now, this one was a little more interesting, as if you can see here, there is on the real RX-7 a strap on the top of the front seat that holds the seat belt and guides it down to the seat. So what I had to do was use a little bit of leftover photo etch material, and with a little bending and twisting here and there, and then glue it down to the seat. I have my seatbelt guide, similar to what's on the real car. And here we have the belt running down to the side of the seat with the buckle, and the other half of the belt is going to be attached to the B pillar in the body of the car. So now I will have to repeat this process on the other seat, for both the front and the rear. And that's going to be on the next video, so that you guys can follow me along and see exactly how I did that. And then the only other thing that will be left on this car is the door panels. As you can see here, Tamiya did not add any detail whatsoever to the door panel. And that just doesn't really work for me. So I'm doing a little bit of research on that door panel. I want to see what kind of armrest or door pulls it had. And then I'm going to try and replicate that on these door cards just to see if I can get it to at least give some sort of detail there. I mean, you're not going to see much when you look into the car, but you will be, at least be able to see that there is something there as opposed to these blank door cards. I mean, there's literally no detail at all there other than this small curve going up. That I find really disappointing, especially from Tamiya. I'm really surprised at that. So, that's going to be something I'll have to address. Now, one thing they did a very nice job with are the pedals. As you can see here, they're all painted up, done and attached. The mounting position of the pedals is really neat the way they did this. Two small little pegs that the pedal assembly rests on, which keeps them off the floor, so they're actually elevated off of the floor. Let's see if we can get a good look at that there. Which looks really good. Way to go, Tamiya. That part you did a really good job with. But these door panels, I'm not happy with that. So I'll have to see if there's anything I can do to make that better. Because even with the dash in, it's just one big empty space there. And that's just bugging me. Maybe it's just my OCD. May not even be worth bothering with, but I am going to give that a try. So that is going to put a little bit of a delay. As for the seatbelt, this is the photo etch material. Now, what I got this from was the leftover photo etch from the seatbelt kit. I cut it off into a straight strip and then I just cut and bend until I get the shape I need. Let me see if I can give you a really good look at that. There it is. Then I get the shape I need to attach to the seat, and then I just run the seat belt through it, and there we go. We have seat belt mounted into the seat. All right, guys, that was just a quick video to give you an update as to where I'm at with the kit. This is going to take me a little while to figure out what I'm going to do about the door cards, so it is slowing this down a little bit, but you'll be along for the ride, so you'll know as soon as I do. All right, guys, we're going to leave it at that. And remember, give a like, give a subscribe. Follow along. It's a fun build, and it's getting more interesting as we try and figure out how to modify and change things. So if you're curious as to how I do all of this, the next video, I'm going to walk you through the installation of the seat belts. And we'll start planning out what we're doing with the door panels. All right, guys, I will see you on the next one.